A cultural exchange for China's president. Part of what David Cameron hoped would be a golden era for UK-China relations. But a privately funded report claims around this time, Beijing began an effort to influence elite figures in British politics, business, even academia.
I think it's a sort of a rainbow of people that help it out. Some completely innocent and unaware, because I'm afraid that our knowledge of China and the way the Communist Party works in this country is not what it should be. Through to people who might be, I think the old phrase might be useful idiots, and through to those who are bought, not necessarily by bags of gold, but by a salaried post, expenses, flattery, whatever it is, finally going through to the sort of agents of influence and espionage.
Former British spy Christopher Steele also helped compile the report. He made headlines for a different dossier on Russia and Donald Trump. This time the focus is China's ruling party and the technology firm Huawei. The client, a US film producer who paid tens of thousands of dollars for the information.
This is not an American trying to go after the United Kingdom. This is trying to be supportive of togetherness, the fact that we're both getting assaulted.
The head of the FBI also sounding the alarm.
The Chinese government is engaged in a broad, diverse campaign of theft and malign influence, and it can execute that campaign with authoritarian efficiency. They're calculating, they're persistent, they're patient, and they're not subject to the righteous constraints of an open democratic society or the rule of law.
China's ambassador to the UK has strongly denied claims of Chinese interference.
If you have evidence, please show me. But do not make disinformation, false accusation against China.
Huawei refutes all claims in the report about its activities. But this is a sensitive time. The firm's role in the UK's 5G future already in the balance. Unplug Huawei, though, and Britain's connection with China may also go dark. Deborah Haynes, Sky News.